You guys are probably asking yourselves, hey, what am I watching here? Slow down. Well, brace yourselves, America. You are watching exclusive behind-the-scenes footage of a pre-celebrity.
We found this study that graduating seniors, they told them what they want to be when they grow up, and 40% said famous. That was the biggest line. Like, the second was like doctor at like 5% or something.
Yeah, I love working with Bo. I mean, he is the funniest person I've ever met. I saw him on YouTube. I was just so impressed. It was kind of the beginning of our friendship.
I didn't know of Bo. I hadn't heard of Bo. He's huge on YouTube and everything.
Those in glass houses shouldn't throw stones or masturbate in the daytime.
That's really, you know, quite a talented guy. And that introduced me to the world of Bo.
I, Zach Stone, graduated from high school. Today is the first day of the rest of my life. Good. Good, guys. Intimate. Aren't you guys in the shot?
It's about a kid who decides, rather than going to college, to spend the money that he's saved up to hire a camera crew to film his own life.
It's kind of about him bringing these cameras into his life and the life of his family and friends, and how disruptive reality TV is to reality.
And he kind of has an early life crisis and hires this camera crew to film him so that he can prove himself before the end of summer when we all go off to school and, you know, have his 15 minutes of fame.
A lot of young people place a great importance on just being famous. Not even to be a superstar basketball player or whatever. The doing the basketball, I guess, is secondary to just the being famous.
What are all the different ways that people are now on television, reality TV, trying to become famous? And that's basically what Zach has done. Zach has gone, okay, I can do that, I can do that, I can do that, I can do that. And so he's basically pinpointed all these things and said, well, let's try it.
He tries to be like a recording artist, but in his own way. He might try to make a sex tape, he might try to go missing.
If you ever want to see me ever again, you must alert all the major news outlets of my disappearance.
He might try to cook some things.
Welcome to Zach's kitchen, mate. We are cooking a little bit of...
There's a rock in this. Are you joking?
So I play Zach's best friend. And, you know, we've been friends since kindergarten.
She's a smart, pretty, funny, cool girl. Like, the most watchable, beautiful thing in Zach's life, but it's the one thing that he isn't comfortable bringing into the show.
That's my good friend, Amy. great girl, but I don't really see how she fits into the show. You know, she's not the goth girl, she's not the cheerleader, and she definitely doesn't fit into the girl next door role. She actually lives four doors down.
What do you do with, you know, a crush that you've had since you were a child, now that you are about to go off into, you know, the real world of being an adult?
We feel like the relationship with Zach and Amy, with, you know, him being this salesman and this having to always sell and perform for the cameras, and then wanting to protect her from that side of him, we felt like we'd never seen that before.
Why won't you let the camera see me?
Because it's complicated, okay? It's...
Really, are you embarrassed of me or something?
No, why? Obviously, I'm not embarrassed of you.
Then why are you doing this? It's crazy when you've known someone that long, and all of a sudden, they've gone from being your best friend to something more. We kind of go through this roller coaster where at one point, I feel a certain way, and then at another point, you know, Zach feels a certain way, and so it's, we seem to miss each other.
Stop, don't be weird. Hey guys, this is my best friend, Greg LeBlanc.
Hello.
Hey, Greg.
Hey,
Greg.
What's up? I think Greg really idolizes Zach and like really looks up to him, so they have a complicated thing where he's probably mistreated a little bit, and it's like a little bit of a sidekick syndrome, you could say.
We have the chance now. We can be anything we want to be, okay?
We're just like, just gonna be ourselves or just be more real?
Yeah, let's be real, Greg. Let's see how that works. Hey, I'm Zach. This is my best friend, Greg. He shaves once every 2 hours. I shave once every 2 months.
Yeah, he works at the film shop, or as they say, the video store, which is going out of business because that doesn't exist anymore.
He seems to be like the clumsy, sad one, but I think, in my opinion, he's much happier and more comfortable with himself than Zach is.
I am lucky enough to have two loving and open-minded parents who are beyond supportive of my decision to spend my entire life savings on a reality show about myself. So,
it's the dumbest thing you've ever done, Zach. I play Mr. Stone, his dad, who, oddly enough, disagrees strongly with that. And he thinks that Zach is just doing something incredibly stupid with his life. If he would only wake up, get a pair of topsiders, get some plaid shorts, and get with the program.
I do these silly, ridiculous, offensive, or inappropriate things, and you see these real people, this real sweet couple having to deal with it. It immediately makes it funnier.
You have worked for 3 years at the grocery store saving all that money. Are you sure you want to spend it on this?
Do I want to spend my money on my dreams? Let me think about that. Ding, yes.
Mr. and Mrs. Stone are your basic caring parents. They want the best for their son. We, of course, as parents, would rather that he go to college. He's a smart kid, and he's just saying no. No, 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 no.
His father's like asking, like, be a man once in a while. His mother's like, do something around the house for once. And his brother's like, don't embarrass me and make me wish I wasn't in your gene pool every single second. I played the game for 12 years. Grades, plays, sports, extracurriculars, philanthropy. I was a bit of a Woody Allen meets Jason Statham, Ferris Bueller.
What the f*** are you doing in my room?
Oh, cut, please. I'm just...
Dude, what did you do to my posters?
I don't want to have clearance issues, Andy.
Zach, get out.
It's over your head.
Get out.
Okay.
Wardrobe change.
He is just an all-American athlete, you know? He gets really good grades in school. He pretty much always gets what he wants. Zach and I are always really competitive.
He's handsome, he gets the girls, and he's just, you know, everything you wouldn't want your younger brother to be.
Morning.
Andrew!
How much longer is this gonna be happening?
Until your brother gets famous.
Oh, cool. So forever.
Zach is facing the question that we all face when we're 18, and the life that we know is coming to an end. I think it's just something we can all connect with because we're all going through it. Maybe we're just not so loud about it.
We're doing a show about a guy who just wants to be famous above all things. And it seems like everywhere in our entire culture is screaming that.
Really coming from the same places that a lot of stories about kids have been, which is like wanting to grow up, wanting to be accepted, wanting to be loved, wanting to be cool. But it's now just with this wild new medium, which is like fame as a pursuit.
Viewers can expect to see a lot of fun, a lot of craziness. They can expect to laugh a lot.
I think it's really honest, and it's not very cartoony or anything. It's very real, and I think there's something beautiful about that.
I think this is a show, interestingly enough, that a lot of different kinds of people will want to watch.
I think it's sweet. I think it's real. I think it's a bit sad. Every episode is very, very different and distinct, which I think is fun. I don't think you're going to expect where it's going.
Bo and I just wanted to create something where you feel like at the end of the day, everyone cares about everyone. Because I feel like those are moments you want to hang on to. Or characters you want to tune in to see again.
I'm Zach Stone, and the world may not know it yet, but, I'm going to be famous.
Cut. Nailed it.